Peter Jackson's World War I documentary, They Shall Not Grow Old, is not only an achievement in film restoration, but also an impactful and intelligently made film that conveys the many emotions felt by soldiers during war. It is at once hilariously charming and horrifically brutal, but entirely poignant. The film begins with black and white footage, the images presented in their original aspect ratio, with minor restoration done to the film. The soldiers themselves narrate the film using interviews conducted in the 60s and 70s. We never see these veterans being interviewed, and we never know if they're in the scenes on screen. We also never see historians or hear from them. This is a similar technique used by Asif Kapadia in his documentaries Senna and Amy. Just like with those films, the choice to never use interview footage makes the film more immersive, as we never leave these soldiers' sides. After signing up for the war effort and surviving boot camp, these British soldiers, many of whom weren't even 18 years old yet, are thrust into the never-ending agony and horror of trench warfare. This is the point in which the film goes into color, and it's the moment we as an audience can begin to fully relate to these soldiers. The restoration is a marvel to behold, a showcase of how technology can update old footage to the point of looking modern. The soldiers seem full of life in comparison to the black and white footage. Their skin is tangible, their different smiles shine into the camera. Yet, this also makes the dead bodies and eviscerated corpses all the more horrifying. Where there is once life, there is now a very distinct death. The color has left their bodies, and these discolored figures are covered in blood and gore. Another important aspect in conveying the experience is the inclusion of sound. The sound effects and voices added to the footage do so much work to put the audience into the moment. The voice acting is lined up near perfectly with the footage, and the Foley work is superb. There's a sequence where the soldiers describe invading the German army, and the screen goes dark with only the sounds of war filling the theater. It's a haunting experience where exploding artillery, agonizing screams, and whizzing bullets are all that remains. By the end of the war, once everyone has returned home, I was struck by how mistreated and uncelebrated these soldiers' efforts were. Many were unemployed, struggling with physical and mental wounds, or simply being mistreated by their fellow citizens. Yet, a few of the soldiers remarked that it made sense to them. As these were civilians, there was no way they could even conceive of what the soldiers had been through. I then realized why Peter Jackson made this movie. For modern people, it's impossible to understand what trench warfare is like, and black and white footage can only be so relatable. We don't see the world in black and white, or without sound, so it's difficult for film from that era to perfectly reflect what the soldiers saw. There is always a distance from what's happening on screen. In the same vein, these young soldiers could not understand what war was like because all they had were photos or illustrations, things edited and created as propaganda. The only people who understood what it was like to be in combat, to see your fellow soldiers killed en masse, are other veterans. Even veterans from other militaries have more in common with the British soldiers than their own countrymen. Because of this, these men have a shared experience that creates a special bond, one that most people at that time, or even today, can never fully understand. By restoring this footage to the point where it looks and sounds like something shot today, it makes the horrors of war all the more horrific, and these soldiers all the more relatable. While audiences who have not experienced combat will never truly know what it's like, they can at least listen and sympathize with those that have. And Jackson's film helps with just that. They Shall Not Grow Old, because it would be a disservice to forget about the struggles these young men went through, or to forget about how they, and many soldiers to this day, are mistreated and lied to for the sake of fighting senseless wars when all anybody wants is for these battles to be over.